I'm very pleased to welcome you to a futures-oriented seminar, Nanotechnology, Food, Agriculture and Development. I strongly believe that we better get ready to look at the new science and technology opportunities in the making, which will impact on and change the functioning of the whole food value chain as we know it today in the next generation. Lots of scientists and people in the food industries are convinced of that. We have a superb panel today which is addressing us. We will have three brief presentations. First by Mikhail Rocco. Mike Rocco is a senior advisor for nanotechnology at the National Science Foundation and a key architect of the National Nanotechnology Initiative, the NNI. Dr. Rocco has 13 patents. He has written several books on nanotechnology. Under his stewardship, the nanotechnology federal investment has increased from about $3 million to $1.5 billion over a number of years. He is a journal editor. He has been elected as the Engineer of the Year by the U.S. Society of Professional Engineers and NSF twice, in 1999 and in 2004. He was awarded the National Materials Advancement Award from the Federation of Materials Societies at the National Press Club in 2007. And he is the founding chair of the U.S. National Science and Technology Council, the NSTC Subcommittee on Nanoscale Science. Ladies and gentlemen, IFPRI is not known for its strength in nanotech or related policy analysis, but we feel we have to get into this field. I will introduce our two other panelists before they speak. We approach the issues very much from a developing country perspective. If we look at India and China, both countries have gone big into nanotechnology science and into the related nanotech applications in food, food processing, food production, environmental cleanup, water cleaning, and so on. Billions of dollars they are investing. Indian government, for instance, is looking towards nanotechnology as a means of boosting agricultural productivity in the country. Have identified nanotech research as one of its six top science investment areas for the five-year plan 2007 to 2012. They are creating a National Institute of Nanotechnology in Agriculture, focusing on nano sensors and nano-based smart delivery systems. Is at the forefront there, making plants more efficient in nutrient take-up, making the food system more sensitive to pathogens, and so on. So the Indian government has gone into that. I was listening to the science minister of China in a meeting in March in Beijing. Again, a long litany of hopes of investment priorities in China moving at extraordinary growth rates. But there are also those who warn. Quoting M.S. Swaminathan, who is well known at IFPRI, the father of India's Green Revolution, who says, should be cautious. If technology has applications, it has limitations too. Right from the beginning, M.S. Swaminathan says, it's advisable to have a national regulatory commission on nanotechnology so that people don't get into litigation later. So today I wish we get, and I think we will get, a lot of insights into opportunities, but also into some of the risk issues and regulatory issues.